Oh. Dag Poes. Hello. So, I add some light. Because usually when I record this kind of videos at 8 o'clock, there's no light. So, I changed... Well, I put the socks on. I changed my room again. Because previous version results in a lot of low end, which is nice, but not so nice. It's a bit close, so I'm able to sit a little bit further away without a wall in the back. I could show you, but it is kind of, you know. So my room is quite large, long, so it seems. That's my, my clothing. The way I had it previously is having a wall in my back. So now I don't. I did this one once with the mini monitors, etc. So I'm gonna play a few songs. They're all scores. Because yeah, scores are nice. But it's different scores. So it's like film scores and... I switched it around. So film score, game score, film score, game score, I think. Let me see. Film score, game score, film score, game score, game score. So some of the game scores are not made with like a full orchestra thing, but there's also a song from the same guy I used previously from Lost, the Michelino Giovanni, Michael Giovanni. It's kind of hard. But he made a lot of, he started off, I think, by making game scores, which are one of the best. And there's also one of, maybe someone knows, I don't know, but it's like a classic. It's a Red Alert, or in this case, it's Generals. But it's from the same game franchise, which is really nice. And this one, it's nice. It's chemical. I mean, it's not made with normal instruments. It's sample based. But still, well done. Very nicely done. And something from... I forgot the game. Also, some sort of same sort of game, but from Microsoft. It's... I forgot, but it's a song that if you got some resonance, it will show up straight away. Oh, I see one of my socks is the wrong way around. So the hole of the left panel in the sock is where the terminal is sitting normally. So it should be the other way around. But I don't care. I mean, the terminals are not in place, as you might have guessed, because otherwise this would not work. So, let's move on. Let's do this. Oh, wait. I did change the filter as well. I was wondering. I use 6 dB per octave filters very often. In this case, I use 12 dB per octave filter. But it's a bit the more the method the MagnaPen uses. So, you got a coil that is falling off early. And then, you know, a normal, second order, you will have aligned these, the coil and the cap. So instead of 6 dB per octave, it moves, or it removes 12 dB per octave. In the MagnaPen, they used it differently, I think. They had a coil that is dropping off earlier, and then when they decided, this is where we're going to cross the tweeter. We put a cap in there. So that's what I did. So it ends up being a 12 dB per octave filter, but the curve is different. That's why you got this BR 12 dB per octave filter and LR from Language Riley. It's purely either the coil value or the cap value that determines how much it rolls off, when it does roll off, whatever. So it's really weird that they, I don't know, it looks quite simple, but apparently it's the liquid royal, eh? I wonder why they never thought about that before, to just take a different value for your cup. I don't know, but I guess there's something to it. I mean, maybe face issues or something, I don't know. But I did the same. So in the magnet pen, they can get away with it with using one cap and one coil, but still create a 12 to be per octave field. But this only works if you got it like perfect. I mean, in terms of if the tweeter is indeed want to drop off at the same rate where you put the cap, for instance. I don't know, it's, you know, I don't mind putting a cap extra in there or a coil extra. I mean, it's not costing that much. So I did it in DSP, but I can translate this to a passive filter if I wanted. And I'm not sure if I want it. Well, that's amazing. Did you hear that girl shouting? That's my neighbors. So I wish them luck with this music. Because I think they can hear them, the music as well. So this is this straight in the middle? It's always hard to see. I think this is kind of echoes. It's pointing upwards. Hello. Okay. That went into the limiter. Yep. Let's go. So it's a playlist this time. I kind of looked for songs I wanted to play instead of doing it randomly. So first of all, Chocolate, the score from the movie Chocolate. Then we'll get some Generals, music from the Chinese faction. And then we're playing some Catch Me If You Can. Then some Call of Duty, and then some... yeah, I forgot the name of the game, but fuck it. So by adding the fabric again,
I damped the main resonance as well. It's like 3 dB or something. So there's not as much 50 something hertz resonance there. Also, a thing that I changed is I had these magnets on the side of the tweeter panel. I removed them all because it created distortion. It did increase the output on the top end, which might be noticeable in the previous video. It had a little bit of sharp edge, a little bit too much in my opinion, but it measured well. But when I changed the room, apparently in the direction I had the thing playing, it had like a boosted low end, which made it kind of flattish. But now when I changed it in the long direction of my room, I actually don't need that much of oomph in the tweeter. So I removed all these magnets, so it is more like well, no resonances. Still, I could use a little bit more of oomph in the tweeter department to just fine-tune it without, well, running it to its limit. Not by any means in like overdoing it, but more like I don't want to pat the woofer down. So it would be nice to have some extras on the tweeter. What's up, Puss? Puss is playing with some screws. Oh, sorry. Oh, she's scared. Scared of some screw, wood screw. So I bumped this one. Okay, next. Player, what you're doing? Next song. This is from the game, Command and Conquer Generals. Love the game, love the sound, love everything about it. I hardly play it, but I love it anyways. you can.
Thank you. remind you, I don't earn any income from this kind of videos.
It's purely because it's fun.
Last game score? And I forgot the name. I'm gonna look it up. So that's usually a thing where you can hear distortion quite clearly.
I was listening 2 meters behind, or a meter behind the camera, so 2 meters behind the recorder, and there it sounds even more impressive, but it's kind of weird. It's far away, but it's my room playing up, creating some really deep low end, which is not something the speakers do. I mean, 50 hertz and then that's it. So yeah, some game scores, some scores. See you next time, and hopefully we can build something again. But I do these videos just because I feel like it and I share some music that I like and maybe someone else likes. It's sort of a win-win. I mean, you've seen the speakers before, or heard the speakers before. So, see you next time. Bye-bye.